CBD, or cannabidiol, is a compound found in cannabis plants, so either hemp plants or marijuana plants, and it is not intoxicating. It cannot get you high, even if you try very hard, but it does have an array of health benefits. CBD is not just another millennial fad. This is not the next avocado toast. Really, everyone is using and consuming CBD, everyone from baby boomers and above, down to millennials and below. The CBD industry, it's like a lightning rod. It's growing rapidly, and we think it's going to be a $22 billion industry by 2022. People use CBD as an anti-inflammatory agent. People use it for pain, sleep, and mood, and just general overall wellness. CBD can get into other products by just being extracted from the green material in the cannabis plant. That will happen through either CO2 extraction or ethanol extraction, and then a distillation process. And again, that is oil soluble, and people can put that into anything from cosmetics to tinctures to soaps. CBD gets into a beverage by using something else to help it suspend in water, because CBD itself is not water soluble. Cannabidiol is a diol, which means it is oil soluble, not water soluble. Most of the ways that CBD beverages are made are with something called polysorbate 80. That is an emulsifier that is used in everything from vaccines to ice cream, and unfortunately isn't always on the label. So do your research on polysorbate 80, and if you feel comfortable with that, then just know that that's probably how CBD got into your beverage. CBD is best used when taken every day. It tends to build up in your body and has that compounding effect over time that will lead to increased anti-inflammatory effects, and anti-inflammatory means general wellness and a better health profile overall. So again, you can use CBD here and there, but it's really best used on a daily basis. There are also two different ways to consume CBD, and one way to consume CBD is a CBD isolate. Isolated CBD is just that crystallized molecule. It is only cannabidiol and does not have anything else in it. And another way is CBD with a full spectrum product. That's basically a whole flower extract that's going to have other cannabinoids in it, terpenes and flavonoids, and that adds to something called the entourage effect. The entourage effect means that you can get a better response at a lower dose than CBD isolate. So I do recommend full spectrum products over isolated CBD, although it's a little hard to get full spectrum into a beverage and have it be tasteless. I like to describe it as the difference between a packet of vitamin C powder you might put into your beverage versus an orange, a whole fruit. So if you don't have anything, sure, use a packet of vitamin C powder, but if you have the option, take the orange. There's a lot of CBD companies out there right now, and there's a lot of misinformation on the internet about CBD, and you really need a scientist to make sure that this is done correctly, done safely, and is going to be both effective for use and safe for consumption.